Before you put in more transactions, you must be able to change a transaction that was already recorded. QuickBooks calls changing a transaction editing a transaction. You can change any part of any transaction that you have already recorded anytime you want to. The results on the reports will change immediately. Let's take a look at an example. Let's change the January 5th money amount to $100,000 and let's see what happens on the trial balance. Okay, here we are in the register window. Here's January 5th and here's the money amount. Let's highlight the money amount, overtype it with the new number that we want to record. That's all you have to do. Click into the field of the piece of information you want to change, then just push tab and it will save the new information. Now when we record the change, QuickBooks gives you a warning message to make sure you're not doing it by accident. You have changed the transaction. Do you want to record the changes? Let's click yes. And then of course click yes past this message. This is an advertisement that you can just close out. Aha. Notice the ending balance in the register changed immediately to a negative 87,100. When you look on the trial balance, it also says 87,100, but the balance has moved from the debit column to the credit column. You do not need to know the principles of debits and credits. The only thing you need to know is that cash would normally have a debit balance, but if it goes negative, it goes into the credit column instead of having a negative sign in front. Now, when we look back on the January 5th transaction, we see that the account is delivery expense. When we look at delivery expense now, it says $100,000, right? That's because we changed the only transaction where we had delivery expense to $100,000. Now let's examine this a little further. Let's change the expense account of January 5th's check from delivery expense to telephone expense and see what happens. Right now, delivery expense is $100,000 and telephone expense is $1,400. If we go back here and change the January 5th expense from delivery expense to telephone expense, when we click record, we get the normal warning that we click yes past. This is something we just click yes past. Now notice cash did not change, but when we click on the trial balance, you can see delivery expense has completely disappeared and you can see telephone expense has become $101,400. If we double click inside the telephone expense account by double clicking on the total balance, here are all the transactions that were recorded in the ledger account telephone expense. The January 6th and January 8th transactions are the ones that we recorded before and they are fine. However, the January 5th transaction is now showing up in the telephone expense account because we changed the expense account in the register to be telephone expense. And that explains the change in the general ledger and the trial balance. Let's make sure to change it back. Let's go back to the register, click on the January 5th transaction, change it back to delivery expense, change the money amount back to $900, push tab to save the field, or maybe it won't, I don't know. Click yes to save the change, and yes pass the annoying message. Cash balance goes back to what it normally would be, and delivery expense balance goes back to what it was. Changing the date of a transaction has a special kind of effect that you must be aware of. The transactions show up in a different place if you change the date of a transaction. That's because the register shows the transactions in date order. Changing the order of the register to order entered would help show you where the transaction is if you cannot find it. Let's take a look. For example, let us change the date from the January 3rd transaction And let's make the January 3rd transaction become January 10. So now check number 2 is going to jump to the bottom because it will have the latest date. When we click record and we click yes and click yes, notice check number 2 has jumped to the bottom. Check number 2 now has the latest date of all the transactions, and that's why it's jumped to the bottom. You can notice now the checks are not in numeric order, even though you wrote them in numeric order over time. That would indicate that there must have been a change in one of the dates. Well, how can you see that if you look later? Well, if you look here at the bottom left of the register window, let's look a little bit closer. And here we are in the bottom left of the register window. There's a tool called Sort By. Let's bring this up a little higher. Right now, the default is sorting by date. But one of the Sort By choices that you can make is sort by order entered. QuickBooks knows the order in which the transactions were entered regardless of what date you put when you recorded the transaction. So when we click order entered, notice January 10th will jump way up high. Let's take a look at that again. Let's just change it back to the default date, type, and reference number. The order now is date first and reference number second. So now when we change the order to order entered, look what happens to check number 2. Aha, it jumped from the bottom all the way back to its original position, even though the date says January 10. That's because sort by is order entered. Of course, to fix everything, the normal proper way to leave your register is date order. So we should really change this back to January 3rd. Click record, click yes for the change, yes to pass the annoying message, and then check number 2 jumps up to its original spot. Remember, the normal way to view your register is date order. You can explore and experiment with any of these other choices, but I can tell you only this choice will make the running balance a legitimate valid column. The running balance in this column is supposed to show you the balance on a specific date. If you remove date order and sort it into any other kind of order, the running balance is meaningless and arbitrary and is not showing you the balance on the date of the same row as the transaction. The only way to get the running balance to show the balance on the day of that transaction is to make sure the order is date order.